If you thought writing code with ChatGPT was cool, then you are in for a treat. OpenAI is changing the game of generative AI. 2 years ago, when generative AI launched, ChatGPT launched, it took over the space. And since then, this is the biggest change that OpenAI has announced, and it is going to change how all of us use generative AI. Custom GPT builders. Yes, you heard that right. Now, anyone and everyone can create their own custom GPTs based on their knowledge, skills, and everything. And there is going to be a GPT marketplace where you can actually make money. I actually played around with the custom GPTs and I built two GPTs, which I'm going to walk you through in a little bit. One for learning data analytics and second for learning Python. Think of like an app store, like an Apple app store or Google app store. In the app store, anyone can create an app and publish it to the app store. Now, what OpenAI did, they introduced custom GPTs and they're planning to introduce a marketplace, not yet introduced, but they're planning to do that, where anyone can create custom GPT based on their knowledge and introduce it in the marketplace where other people can buy and play around with it. Now, anyone can monetize their knowledge using ChatGPT. This is revolutionary. This is going to change the game of how ChatGPT, how generative AI, and how any of the other generative AI tools that exist out there works. Still don't get it? Let's go to ChatGPT and let me show you what I actually mean. This is the data analyst GPT that I built and it's available for public. You can find the link in the description if you want to play with it. Now you must be wondering that ChatGPT already has the capability to write Python code for you and do data analysis with you with advanced analysis. So what makes this different? The difference is the customized GPTs, which is based on my knowledge and my experience and my technical skills over the last 10 years. I have specific style and preferences when it comes to writing code and doing custom analysis. And now you can leverage my 10 years of experience using custom GPTs. Let me show you the data analyst custom GPT that I built, and then I'll show you like how you can build your own GPT. So this is the custom data analyst GPT that I built. Basically, I have programmed it so it knows that it's a data analyst who can help with data analysis. Think of it like a data analyst consultant. You're basically hiring somebody to do your work. So this person can do the data analysis for you, create visualization for you in a storytelling way, and you can also upload your data and create beautiful visualizations based on specific libraries and visualization preferences that I personally like to use in my day-to-day work. So let's upload one file and let's play around with it. One thing I do want to mention, that uploading file capability is only available for paid subscriptions. So the upload feature might not work for you if you don't have a paid subscription, but you can use the rest of it. You can give it a summary of the data and get analysis code and visualization code as well. Okay, so let's upload one file. I'm going to upload levels.fyi salaries. So what I'm going to tell it is analyze this data for me and tell me what custom analysis I can do. Now I'm going to hit send. It's currently analyzing data for me. Well, it gave me a bunch of options that I can use for diversity analysis, educational impact, role-specific analysis. So let's say I'm job searching and I want to make sure like I prioritize my data analyst skill set based on what the job market is paying. So I can use this data and I can ask it, like, I want to use it to narrow down my job search and figure out which companies I want to target. So let's see what it gives me. So what I want to do is identify the top paying companies, and then I want to know where I should be targeting my search. You can also use this to learn data analytics if this is something that if you're just starting out with data analytics. It has a lot of the basic fundamental concepts, for example, like writing your Excel formulas, doing A/B testing, specific A/B testing approaches that I personally like to use. You can also leverage that. Okay, so it basically created this beautiful visualization with x-axis being company and y-axis being average total yearly compensation in USD. This looks pretty neat. I can keep going and ask it to do more things, but let's actually focus on one example where I want it to teach me a concept. So I have programmed it to teach me in a certain way that I personally like. Like, I like a very simple and literally a dumbed down version of things when I'm trying to learn new things. So what I'm going to say, can you help me learn incrementality analysis techniques and give real world examples? Okay, so I really like the methodology approaches that it's giving me. It's not bombarding me with too much information. And this is why I love the custom GPTs, because I can program it to like make it like more specific and more concise. On the topic of data exploration, I wanted to share this super cool data analysis template, which is super handy for data exploration. Especially, let's say if you are working with a new data set, you can use these to figure out what kind of visualizations would make sense. It is created by HubSpot, who is also sponsoring this portion of the video. The template comes with two Excel files, one basic, one advanced. So you have plenty of visualizations to work with. For example, let's say I'm working with orders data and I want to get orders data placed by timestamp. There is so many ways I can visualize it. And obviously I'll use Python functionalities to do some exploration, but I want to do a quick and dirty analysis. I can borrow these any of these visualizations and plug and play in Excel over Google Sheet to quickly find trends. Looking at these plots is actually a good mental exercise to find the right graphs that works for your data. I'm linking the Excel template below. It's available for free. Feel free to download it. Now let me show you the Python custom GPT that I built. Okay, so this is the custom Python GPT that I built. I basically asked it to focus on data analysis and data science techniques when giving me Python teaching material. So for example, let's say I wanted to teach me how to learn Python when I have knowledge of SQL. Can you give me some examples? So now it has specifically started to give me like SQL syntax. I've also programmed it to tell me like what kind of SQL I'm coming from. And then it gives me basically the SQL syntax and then the parallel of Python. This is super helpful for somebody who is familiar with SQL but is new to learning Python. And one of the things about this Python teacher, if you're like doing any sort of like generating code or visualizations, it's going to teach you while it creates it, versus like in a regular ChatGPT, you are basically getting an answer without like having very deep understanding. So for example, here, it like kind of like teaches you why it exactly chose bar plot, how it created it, and it also gives me the code behind it, which I believe is somewhere right here. So it gives me the code and I can basically copy paste it, and it shows me the output as well, and I can like customize it. I can also copy it and put it into VS Code or any of my other tools and then customize it further, or I can just ask ChatGPT to do that for me. Now let me ask it, how do you do regression analysis in Python? This is one of my favorite questions. And one of the things that you will notice that it is keeping a very simple language, which is what I really, really like to do, especially for people who are new to the space. Keeping a simple language makes it easy to understand for new people. And this is what this custom GPT does. Again, I didn't put too much time into this because I'm not planning to sell it. This was just me playing around with the Python, with the custom GPTs. Okay, let me show you where you can access the GPT. So what you do is you go to your regular ChatGPT. I have a paid subscription, which I just got to try out the custom GPTs because I wanted to build one. So I'm currently on 3.5, which is what the view you will have if you don't have the subscription. So I go to explore page. Here you will actually start seeing like some of the GPTs that I have built. I can create my own custom GPT, which I'll show you in a minute. Then these are some of the GPTs that I've used. And then these are the GPTs that are created by OpenAI. For example, let's say ChatGPT Classics, Game Time, The Negotiator, Creative Writing Coach, Cosmic Dream, Tech Support Advisor. Like these are some of the GPTs that are like available for default. GPTs that are created by other people are not available in this marketplace. And I think that's something that will come in the future. But let me walk you through how to create your own custom GPT. So let's say we want to create a data science teacher GPT or learn data science. So what I want to program it, I want to say, I am a data science professor at Berkeley, and I want to teach my students learning data science in simple language using current industry practices. So I just gave it some prompt with a lot of typos, but it's definitely going to understand it. And it's going to ask me more questions. For example, the Python and data analyst GPT, I actually gave it a lot more detailed instructions and then I can configure it later. But basically here, it ended up giving me basically create a custom GPT. So it already named my GPT a helpful guide for learning data science in simple terms. Super cool. It also has some defaulted options which I can choose from, like explain machine learning in simple terms. So I can make it even more specific. I want to say include A/B testing, analysis techniques, and statistics guidelines. So just going back to the response, it basically did a really good job giving me a response on the basic definition, supervised and unsupervised learning, but I can definitely keep building on it. So now we just build the GPT in like 2 seconds, literally. Now what I can do it further is that I can configure it. So like you will see a configure tab here. So you go here, you can name your GPT. Let's say I'm gonna say data science master. I'll link it in the description if you wanna try it out. And then the description is simplifies data science, A/B testing, and statistics. So here are some of the instructions that it has added. So I'm going to like configure it even further. I'm going to say include machine learning fundamentals, such as regression, classification. Again, like I can customize it as much as I want. I can give it as much context as I want. And then I can basically have like specific prompts that I want to show. For example, when you start a GPT, you can have it show a specific prompt. For example, here right now it's focusing on A/B testing, describe common data analysis techniques, and so on. Here, if I get when I have knowledge saved in a file, like a Word doc or a PDF, I can upload it here. And you can also choose like what capabilities do you want to keep in here. So now when I go back to the Explore page, you're gonna see a data science master here. So now if I wanna make it public, the only way you will access it if I make it public, so let's make it public. So I'm gonna say confirm. Now you should be able to access this. All right, so now you should know enough to like create your own custom GPT. This is the coolest thing I've seen since generative AI became mainstream. The potential of this tool is massive. I don't know if you have tried it yet. If you haven't, you should definitely try it. At least play with some custom GPTs to see how it works. Have you tried GPT? And if you have created one, definitely add it to the GPT marketplace that I have built. I'm linking it in the description below. There are several other GPTs that other people have added, so make sure to add yours so other people can try it out, because the marketplace on the OpenAI platform does not exist. So there are like a lot of hacky ways people are sharing and kind of like getting feedback from other people. And if you have any other custom GPT ideas that you want me to create, let me know in comments. With that, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.